With the patient now lying in supine, we are going to take a measurement for hip joint flexion. In this position, we would flex the hip forward, allowing the knee to relax, and I would palpate at the pelvis, specifically the iliac crest, to look for posterior pelvic tilt. At that point, that would indicate the end of hip joint flexion. Our landmarks will be the greater trochanter of the hip. Our stationary arm is along the axillary line of the trunk or level or parallel with the table. Our moving arm is from the trochanter at the hip to the lateral epicondyle of the knee. We would take our measure with the stationary arm aligning in this degree and then use our moving arm along the trochanter to our lateral epicondyle line. That would be a measurement for hip joint flexion.